It's actually...
Get that. Could you try again?
Oh my gosh. I think every time I say series, Siri thinks I'm talking to her. Hey guys, it's Kesara, and today I'm gonna be doing my most surprising books that I read in 2021. I am so excited to get to my most surprising books of the year. These are by far my favorite videos to do every year. I absolutely love doing these videos, and I love watching them. Unfortunately, this year I didn't read as much books as I have in the past few years, because most of the past few years I've been reading significantly over 100 books, sometimes over 200 books, and this year I read close to 80. So still a good amount, but nowhere close to where I have been reading. So instead of doing my top 10 of my most surprising, most disappointing, my worst, and my best books of the year, I'm narrowing it all down to top 5 for each of those categories. So here are my top 5 most surprising books that I read this year. The House in the Cerulean Sea by TJ Klune. So I talked about this recently on my recent reads video, but I definitely have to talk about it when it comes to most surprising books, because I didn't have a whole lot of expectations going into this. Like, I actually dragged my foot a really long time before finally picking this one up. And I think partially is because I picked up the audiobook a couple of times and I didn't love the audiobook, but I still do really love this book. And I think part of the reason why I wasn't that interested in it is because it's about a middle-aged man who goes on this mission to this house that keeps these magical children, which didn't seem that interesting to me. But it's just this wholesome, heartwarming novel that's just so much fun to read. It is absolutely adorable, and it really surprised me because I ended up loving it so much, and I would definitely recommend it. If you're one of the few people that haven't read this book yet, it is such a wholesome, fun, good book that I would definitely recommend that you pick up as soon as possible, because it'll just make you feel so happy. Really love this, and I'm so happy that I finally picked it up. So the next book that I want to talk about is Before the Coffee Gets Cold by, I honestly don't want to butcher this author's name, so I'll just put it on the screen right here. This is actually a time travel novel, but not like your typical time travel novel. So in this novel, there is a seat in this cafe, and if you sit in the seat, you can go to the past. But unfortunately, you can't change the past, but you may be able to change the future. It's definitely an interesting concept. I really liked the very unique style of time travel and the unique style of storytelling. I just got the audiobook for The Tales from the Cafe, which I think is a short story series that's set in this same cafe, but I enjoyed this a lot more than I was expecting. It's a relatively short novel. I feel like it's not one of those novels that like you can know what to expect going into it, because I didn't really have any expectations, but I loved every second of it. It was definitely a huge surprise for me because I didn't have any expectations for this, and I enjoyed it immensely. Would definitely recommend this one. So the next book that I want to talk about is Pride and Prejudice and Other Flavors by Sonali Dave. This book surprised me so much. This is the first book in the Rajas trilogy, which is a series of romantic contemporary novels following an Indian family in America, and also being retellings of the Jane Austen novels, which I love Jane Austen. Pride and Prejudice is by far like my favorite romance of all time, like my favorite absolute. And I'm always looking for good retellings of Pride and Prejudice and literally never finding them. Like almost every Pride and Prejudice retelling that I read, I'm just like, oh, I hated this. But Pride and Prejudice and Other Flavors really worked for me so well. First of all, love both of the characters. And I like that it's gender swapped, because like the Darcy character is the female character in this one, while the male character is like the Elizabeth Bennet of it all. And I love that aspect of it. I think it works really well. But I think what makes this novel, it takes the plot of Pride and Prejudice and it gets the essential thing that makes Pride and Prejudice so great, which I think is really just nailing that one scene. You know that scene where like Darcy confesses love to Elizabeth, but she's not having any of it because she totally hates him at that point? That is like the pivotal moment. And I think this novel nails it so well. It nails it, but it still makes it its own in its own ways. And I just loved every second of it. Also, I mean, like South Asian main characters. Love it so much. Love everything about this series. I've read the other two novels that are already out in the series, Incense and Sensibility and then Recipe for Persuasion, which I haven't actually read Persuasion by Jane Austen, but Recipe for Persuasion was pretty good too. And then I liked Incense and Sensibility. So I liked both of the other ones, but Pride and Prejudice and Other Flavors was the one that just like made me absolutely love this so much. Like it totally worked for me. I was not expecting anything going into it. Like every time I pick up a Pride and Prejudice retelling, I'm just like, I'm gonna hate this. It's gonna be terrible. And I loved it so much. So highly, highly recommend if you haven't read the series. Really, really loved it. And I'm excited to continue on. And the fourth novel in the series, I believe it's called Emma Project, is coming out, which I'm also really, really excited for because I actually do really like Emma. The next book that I'd like to talk about is The Mask of Mirrors by M.A. Carrick. So I recently talked about this book in my recent reads video, so you can check that out if you want a little bit more information on it. But this is a book that I picked up kind of on a whim, and it really, really surprised me. Like, I did not expect to like this book half as much as I ended up liking it. It is a deeply political, like, sort of cloak and dagger fantasy that I absolutely loved. We're following a character named Ren who kind of inserts herself into this noble family and pulls off some cons, but it gets really political, and there's this mysterious figure, and you're trying to figure out who that person is, if they're maybe one of the noblemen or someone else. It's really mysterious in the best way possible and incredibly political and complex and just pretty much everything that I ask from a fantasy novel. I loved every second of it, and I'm also super excited for the sequel, which literally just came out. Hopefully this will end up being one of my new favorite series, but the first one surprised me so much because I literally had zero expectations going in, and I just loved it so, so much. So for the most surprising book of 2021 for me, it has to be From Blood and Ash by Jennifer L. Armentrout. So this is actually one of the first, if not the first books that I picked up in 2021, like way back in January. And this surprised the crap out of me. This was actually the Goodreads Choice Award winner for best romance in 2020. Sometimes when I see books that I feel like I might be interested in that make those lists, I try to pick them up. So I picked up this one, and this one was a complete win for me. Like, I randomly decided to buy this book, and I'm so glad that I did because I enjoyed it so much the first time. I actually read this book twice this year. I read it first with the second book, and then I reread the series later on when Crown of Gilded Bones came out, which is the third book in this series. So yes, really, really enjoyed this first book. Mind you, this is the only one that I enjoyed that much. After the first book, I started to get a little bit annoyed with the series, especially closer to the end, especially with like Crown of Gilded Bones. Like, that one in particular, I really considered putting on my most disappointing books of the year, but that doesn't change how much I actually really, really loved the first book in the series, even though I wasn't expecting to like it that much. If you like Sarah J. Maas and you like vampires, if you put those two things together, you probably get a book somewhat like From Blood and Ash. It was a very interesting concept starting out. Honestly, it took me the longest while to realize this was about vampires. Mind you, these types of novels, I don't tend to read summaries for very much. I kind of like to just dive into them, and I'd never read anything by Jennifer L. Armentrout before. I don't think I'm gonna read a lot of her other series though, because I feel like this is one of the most beloved ones, and I still wouldn't consider the series like one of my favorites, but it was just still highly, highly entertaining. I absolutely love like the drama of the romance in this one, which sometimes drama and romance annoys the crap out of me. For some reason in this one, doesn't annoy me at all. I love every second of it. I'm just like gobbling up the drama in this romance. It's definitely like a guilty pleasure sort of read to me. I loved every second of this, like seriously, every second of this. While some of the other novels in the series I felt like get a little bit repetitive, this first one just really works for me. I didn't even fully realize that it was vampires until like halfway through it. It definitely has like a lot more of a high fantasy feel to it than like most vampire novels. So I really liked that aspect of it too. And I think that's part of the reason why I just loved it so much. So most surprising book of the year for me. And I'm excited to read the rest of the series and the prequel as well. So that's all I have for you guys today. I post videos on Tuesdays and Saturdays, so consider subscribing. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up to support my channel. All social media links are in the description down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.